Hello friends, I hope you like my videos, and if you have any question you can ask me in the comment. So friends, in this video we will discuss about the handling of incident in pharmaceutical industry. Friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality. Please view, like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standard and practices. So now we will discuss what is incident. So any unplanned or uncontrolled event in the form of non-compliance from the designated system, instrument or procedure at any stage of analysis due to system failure or instrument malfunction or manual error, right? So the incident can occur at any point of execution of work. So it may be the quality impacted incident or non-quality impacted incident, right? So now in this slide we will discuss the types of incident. So there are two types of incident. First is minor and second is major. So first we will discuss what is minor incident. So minor incident are those events that have occurred during the execution of an activity that does not involve the analysis of a sample, right? So such incidents can be addressed with appropriate explanation and justification. So this means the incident which are not having the impact on the product quality, right? For example, when product analysis performed on HPLC instrument and incidents observed before the injection or analysis of a sample, then it shall be considered as a minor incident, right? Now the second is major incident. So major incident are those events that have occurred during the execution of an activity that may involve the complete or incomplete analysis of a sample. In such cases, an impact assessment and detailed investigation shall be required, right? So this means the incident which may impact the quality of product, so such incident must be investigated thoroughly, right? For example, when product analysis is performed on HPLC instrument and incident observed after the injection or analysis of a sample, then it shall be considered as a major incident, right? So this is just an example. There may be the different case also, and based on the evaluation we can decide whether the incident is minor or major, right? So now we will discuss a few examples of instrument, equipment and system related incidents, right? So first is non-functioning of instrument or equipment during any analysis. So these may include connectivity and communication failures, or maybe UPS failure, power failure, right? And also it includes the operational software errors, etc. Next is sequence interruption during chromatographic analysis. So these may result due to power backup failure, pressure fluctuation or column leakage, etc., right? Next is system suitability failure. So it may include but not limited to such as similarity factor failure, resolution not achieved as per specification, asymmetry failures or theoretical plates not achieved as per specification, and percent RSD of area failure, and also the retention time not achieved as per specification for a standard, right? So these are the few examples of laboratory incidents, right? Next is retention time shifts observed in any of the runs during chromatography analysis that is beyond the limit of specified in the respective test procedure. Next is unusual chromatography patterns such as noisy or drifting baseline, or maybe atypically observed shape such as any kind of hump or spike on the analyte peak. So such kind of things may happen for the chromatography patterns, right? Next is failure in percent RSD during any analysis. So it may include such as standardization of volumetric solution and standardization of Carl Fischer reagent. So maybe during the analysis of these, percent RSD may fail, right? So these are the few examples related to instrument, equipment and system, right? So now we will discuss the few examples of analyst related incidents, right? So first is incorrect information entered in the sequence. So for example, in the case of chromatographic analysis, such as AR number, batch number, or potency of a standard or label claim wrongly entered, right? Next is during chromatographic analysis, vial position are not properly defined and the same are not kept as mentioned in the sequence, right? Next is incorrect processing method selected. That is during the processing of chromatogram, wrong processing method done with incorrect processing method, right? Next is electronic data is stored outside the designated path or folder, or incorrect file name assigned, or maybe the incorrect sequence name assigned, right? So that is the file name that is not assigned as per the internal standard practice, right? Next is any transcription or typographical error reported in any reviewed document. Next is any spillage of bulk quantity of sample and chemicals or solvent during analysis which has an impact on respective documents such as legibility issue, right? Next is breakage of glassware after weighing or sample preparation during analysis or breakage of glassware during the sonication. Next is incorrect allocation of AR number if the analysis is executed. So these are the few examples related to analyst error, right? So now we will discuss the few examples related to microbiology laboratory related incidents. So first is petri plates drop during the handling. Next is temperature excursion observed during the sterilization cycle. Next is abnormal autoclave cycle termination. Next is autoclave sterilization printer failures. Next is autoclave vacuum leak test failures. Next is incorrect cycle number entered in autoclave system, right? So now we will discuss general guidance on incidents, right? So first is upon occurrence or identification of an incident, the concerned person shall inform to the manager QC or designee about the incident. So whenever the incident is observed, so immediately you need to report that incident to the manager QC or designee, right? Next is an incident shall be logged within one working day from the date of the occurrence or identification. So whenever the incident is identified, so within one working day you need to initiate the incident in the QMS, right? Or maybe if you are following the manual process, so you need to log that incident within one working days. Next is incident closure should be done within 30 working days from the date of the identification. So when you have initiated the incident, so within 30 working days you need to close that incident. If it can not close, then extension can be taken based on the proper justification and QA approval. So you need to give the proper justification and you should take the QA approval to get the extension on that particular incident. So now in this slide we will discuss what are the regulatory guidelines for incidents, right? So first one is 21 CFR part 211, that is current good manufacturing practice for finished pharmaceutical. So what does it guideline says that pharmaceutical companies are required to have procedure in place for investigating and documenting non-conformance, including root cause analysis, corrective action and preventive action, right? So this non-conformance comes under the incidents, right? Next one is the EU GMP guideline, that is Indurelax volume 4. So this guideline says pharmaceutical manufacturers to establish and implement effective system for investigating and addressing non-conformance. This includes procedure for recording non-conformances, assessing their impact on product quality and implementing corrective and preventive actions, right? Next is ICS Q9, that is quality risk management. So ICS Q9 provides a framework for applying a risk management principles to identify, assess and control quality risk, including those related to non-conformance, right? Next is ICS Q10, that is Pharmaceutical Quality System. This guidance emphasizes the importance of an effective pharmaceutical quality system that includes processes for managing non-conformance, deviation, and kappa. It outlines the principle for continual improvement and risk management in pharmaceutical manufacturing. So these four guidelines basically talks about the non-conformance handling, that you can say that is any kind of incidents which observed during the analysis, right? So now in this slide we will discuss the handling of incident, that is details of workflow, right? So first you need to initiate the incident when the incident is identified, right? So after initiation of incident, that incident will go to the section head, and section head will review that incident and provide his comment, right? And after that, that incident will move to the user department head, and then user department head will review the incident and provide his comment. And further, if other department, you know, it is applicable, then other department can also provide his comment. And then it will move to the QA decision. So QA will review that incident, and based on the nature of incident, he will provide his comment, right? And then action plan proposal can be initiated by the user department head or maybe the section head, right? And after the action plan proposal, action plan allocation shall be done, right? And based on the action plan allocation, the respective user shall execute the action plan that is maybe related to you know, investigation. So investigation, further investigation can be initiated, and based on the investigation, what was the root cause, that should be identified, and further based on the root cause identification, kappa shall be proposed, right? And if the kappa is if the kappa is applicable, then you know, action plan closure can be initiated, and effectiveness monitoring of kappa can be open. And after completing this process, incident will go to the closure section, and then user department will close the incident, and finally it will be closed by the HOD if the incident is minor, and in case of major incident, that QA department will close the incident, right? So now we will discuss the practical approach to make an investigation report for incident. So first section is description of incident. So here we need to define the problem statement. So that is the details of incident observed. So let's take one example, that is during the HPLC analysis, the sequence is interrupted, right? So you need to elaborate with respect to that sequence interruption in this problem statement. Then you need to define about the incident number, product name or material name, batch number and AR number, instrument name and instrument ID number, right? And also you can define the stage of analysis and date of occurrence, which includes date of initiation of incident and any SOP number if applicable, right? So such things you need to define. And also you need to define about the who has identified that incident and how it was identified and where the incident was identified. So you need to define like that. And also you need to define the that incident is minor incident or major incident, right? So next is immediate action, right? So here you need to define about the what action you have taken immediately after identifying the incident. So here the action may be you have hold the instrument, incident is initiated and preliminary investigation is performed, and maybe other immediate action you have taken. So such things you need to elaborate. So next section is initial impact assessment. So here you need to define about the impact on product quality, product safety and efficacy, right? Due to the incident observed. So here you can define that your sequence is interrupted before the sample injection, so there will not be any impact on the product quality, right? Next is investigation team member. So here you need to define about the team member, that is who are involved into the investigation, right? That is their name, their designation and their department. So next is investigation findings. So first is process flow. So here you need to define about the what are the process for the analysis, and with respect to that process, what could be the possible error, right? Next is historical check. So here you need to define about the similar type of incident with root cause and kappa taken, right? Next is investigation section. So here you need to elaborate your preliminary investigation or investigation you may perform by the using 5-Y fishbone diagram or maybe hypothesis, right? So here investigation may include preliminary investigation, that is step by step process, and this include basically this depends upon the nature of incident, right? So first is analyst interview. So here you can take the analyst interview and ask the technical question related to process and work execution activity to find out the any root cause. Next is review of laboratory area. So here you can check the control room temperature condition, that is control room temperature is okay or not okay at the time of performing the activity. Next is preventive maintenance verification. So here you can check the completion of preventive maintenance date to evaluate that PM is performed timely, right? Next is review of column. So here you can evaluate the correct column is used during the analysis. Next is analyst detail. So here you can evaluate the involved analyst is well qualified in that particular techniques, right? So next is review of method of analysis. So here you can verify the procedure that analyst is used is correct or not. Next is review of sequence. So here you can check all the information in the sequence, such as vial position, correct method, injection volume, etc. are correctly entered or not, right? Next is review of audit trial. So here you can check the audit trial with respect to the interrupted injection to find out the information detected in the audit trial, right? Next is review of pressure graph. So here you can check the pressure graph of all run injection to identify there is any pressure drop or not. Next is physical verification of instrument. So here you can check the all module of instrument, that is column 1 compartment, pump, auto sampler and detector to identify any leakage, right? Next is reanalysis or recalibration. So here you need to define about the outcome of reanalysis or recalibration after the correction done based on the root cause identified, right? So now next section is human error evaluation, if applicable. So if analyst related incident is observed based on the detailed investigation and finding of root cause, then we need to define about the details of person, right? Next is root cause conclusion. So here we need to define about the details of root cause identified. It may be the instrument related or analyst related error, right? Next is impact assessment based on the root cause identified, that is impact on the batches. So here you can define that there will not be any impact due to that sequence is interrupted before the sample injection, right? So in such a way you can define. Next is kappa and its effectiveness. So here the details of correction, corrective action and preventive action, and the details of kappa effectiveness should be mentioned if kappa has been initiated, right? So whatever I have explained related to incident, that is for the understanding purpose, right? There may be the changes based on the nature of incident. So friends, this is all about the handling of incident in the pharmaceutical industry. I hope it will help to understand. So thank you for watching the video.